Hello everyone and welcome to the live stream. I'm Martin Leung, video game pianist. I've been playing video game music for over 23 years or so and playing piano for over 30 years. And hello to B, YDSMC, Mallory M, David Prodigy, Max Lucas Piano. How are you doing? I really enjoy your performances, Max Lucas Piano. You're the piano duo, I assume. Thank you for stopping by the stream. And hello, Kettle Clog. Hello, Squirrel. Hello, Kevin Leeds. Leonard Smith. Now Hero TV. So I'm going to play some requests that I got two streams ago. So that includes Dark Blue Inn from Paper Mario Color Splash as super chatted by Savvy 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, and a mix of Dire Dire Docks and Rosalina in the Comet Observatory as super chatted by Christopher Antonio. And now, David Prodigy, you mentioned that you made a request, but I searched for your super chat and I couldn't find your super chat. So, so I don't think a super chat request went through. So, David Prodigy, so I don't think that request was a super chat. So, to make a request, you have to make a super chat, and then I will fulfill that request two streams from then. David Prodigy said you were charged. Do you know when you made that super chat? And do you have the stream link or the date of the stream when you made the super chat? Because then I can go back and check that you did make the super chat for it. So let me know the details and you can email me at vgpstream@gmail.com or at the email address in the video description below. But YouTube is really good at keeping track of who makes a super chat, and I looked at the people that made the super chats, and David Prodigy, I didn't see your name listed in the super chat. So let me know the stream for that, because I can research what's going on. And welcome back, Mikey Yan. Good to see you here. And hello, Efrain. Leonard Smith, yes, I'm still trying to become a national master. So I'm on leechess.org. It's video game pianist. You can all follow me there as well. And maybe we might play a chess game sometime. Well, so without further ado, here is Dark Blue Inn from Paper Mario Color Splash. Thank you. Thank you again, Savvy. And Savvy, hope you were able to hear that performance of Dark in what you super chatted. If not, you go back to the live stream and check that out. And hello, One Up Women. Welcome to the stream. Glad you're here. Kettle Clog, I see you played Color Splash. How did you like the game? I still have my old Wii U. No Hero TV. Yes, I can perform the old Mario medley in a current environment. Yes, so I've upgraded that piano. That piano was at my friend Luigi's place, and that's where I played on an upright Kawai piano. And then this piano is a grand Kawai piano. It's a Shigeru Kawai. It's handmade in Japan, so I'm very fortunate to play on this beautiful instrument. Hello, Chad. Hello, Bunjunin's granddad. Longtime fan, much love. One of my favorite videos of yours is Bowser's Inside Story Final Boss theme from several years back. Thanks for sharing your talent with us, keeping awesome. Thank you so much for the kind words, Bundren. I remember making that Bowser's Inside Story Final Boss with the crazy arpeggios in the beginning. I was setting up my GoPro camera and recording that, and it took a few takes to just get the beginning. And once I got the beginning, I felt really happy, but I still had to play the rest of the song for a few more minutes. But that beginning part was the challenging part, because I just had learned that in that day, because I was taking requests each day and I was learning that, and I just I think I just practiced it in one day and learned it. But it's that's how it went. Now here TV, yes, where do you live? I asked you that. All right, so I'm streaming here from Los Angeles, California. Thank you, Chad. And thank you again, Sabby. David Prodigy, it's vgpstream@gmail.com. So let me write it down here. And you also follow me on Twitter too, because if anybody wants to contact me with related, non-stream related questions or comments, I'm on Twitter as well. But I might switch to another platform due to what's going on in Twitter. It's changing. I'm keeping track of what's going on in Twitter, but some people are migrating to different platforms, so I might do that as well, but we'll see what happens. Hello, David L. Sumner, welcome. So you love Sticker Star and Color Splash, even though they're pretty divisive from what I hear, is this Kettle Clog. Kettle Clog with the Mega Man icon. All right, so now the next request is from Christopher Antonio. And Christopher Antonio requested a mix of Dire Dire Docks and Rosalina in the Comet Observatory. So this is what I came up with regards to mixing those two themes. One is in a 4/4 time signature, and one is in a 3/4 time signature. So it was hard to just combine the elements together because they're in different time signatures. So what I did is I combined the water-like motion of the left-hand accompaniment with the Rosalina melody. And that's what I try to combine. So it's like a water element with the Rosalina Observatory, like water and outer space. So if you can imagine those two elements combined, that's that's what I came up with. Thank you. you again, Christopher Antonio. Welcome back. So doesn't it sound better when I spend two more streams to work on the request rather than trying to find the sheet music, spend time looking for the music and sight reading it, and depending on the difficulty level, it's some pieces are easier to sight read than others, but when I have more time to look at the piece and give it some more serious thought and attention, then it just comes out, I think, 100 times better, in my opinion. But it does require some patience on the people that make the super chat requests. It's not like instant gratification. But I think the wait is worthwhile. Thank you, Pam. It's my name. Welcome back. Thank you. And I've been thinking, David Brodigy, I'll give you your request for free. You requested to make some scary music. So I'll, you know, I played that Jaws theme earlier. I'll combine the Jaws theme with the underground theme from Super Mario Brothers 1. How about that? But in the future, YouTube does keep track of all the Super Chats really in an organized fashion, so that people that do make a Super Chat, I see a list of the people that make the Super Chat and request. So hopefully people won't catch on and just say, oh, I made a Super Chat request, and I want my request to fill, but it doesn't work that way, because YouTube really makes that, YouTube keeps a list, a log of all the Super Chats. So people can't just, I'm not saying David Prodigy did this, but people can't just fake or pretend that they made a Super Chat and or claim that they made a request and claim that they made a Super Chat, because I have it all logged in here automatically by YouTube. So without further ado, here's some scary music as requested by David Prodigy, and it's a combination of the Jaws theme and the Super Mario Brothers 1 underground theme. That was scary enough, David Prodigy. So there it is, some Jaws theme combined with Super Mario Brothers underground theme, and then I also got inspired to use the opening rising arpeggio from the Super Mario World Castle theme, as well as part of the accompaniment to the castle theme as well, and also the Infinite Staircase from Super Mario 64. That is a little bit spooky too. And thank you so much, Mikey Ann, for the $10 super chat. Mikey Ann writes, "Hey Martin, since you already played my favorite, I would like to request something relaxing since I'm on vacation. Thanks." Well, I hope you're having a great vacation, Mikey Ann, and thanks for tuning in your vacation. So I'll play something relaxing from my repertoire. So how about the Animal Crossing Wild World theme? I'll play that. And so for the future people that make Super Chat requests that are in my repertoire list, I can play immediately because I know those songs already. But if people request songs that I don't know, then I will need time to look at it more seriously because I want to give my, I want to give good effort and a serious effort to what I play. So, but for Mikey Yan is a longtime viewer and I think he knows my repertoire list pretty well. So here is Animal Crossing Wild World main theme. you, Mikey Yan. So that was Animal Crossing Wild World and some improvisations, because I know Mikey Yan likes those improvisations, sort of like a jazz style. I was trying to channel Keith Jarrett for a moment in some of my improvisations. I was studying this Colon concert that that two people from Japan transcribed, this Colon concert almost 25 years ago, and all those rhythms. It was very, got inspired how he could get into a groove by repeating these rhythmic and harmonic figures over and over and over again with utmost patience. It was really inspiring just to study that improvisation. I'm learning, Keith Jarrett's Memories of Tomorrow. I'll give a sneak preview of that. It goes something like this. Thank you. So that's what I've been working on for the past 6 years or so. It's quite a challenging piece to memorize because there's so many different rhythms and there are multiple melodies going at the same time. But I'm getting there. So thank you again, Mikey Ann. Thank you, David Prodigy. And thank you, Fam4077, for the super chat. Can you play Sonic Ice Cap Zone? And it's freezing here. Well, actually, I do know Sonic Ice Cap Zone. It's in my repertoire list, so I can play it on the spot here. This is Sonic the Hedgehog Zone. Sonic 3 Ice Cap Zone. I'll play the Zone 1 and a little bit of Zone 2 music because the different zones are slightly different music. I think Zone 2 is in a slightly higher register. And by the way, I'm playing Sonic Mania these days. I'm trying to beat the game so that when Sonic Frontiers comes out in a few days, I'll be able to play that. And I'm looking forward to playing Sonic Frontiers. That looks amazing. It takes 30 gigabytes of hard drive space, so I've never had a game that took so much hard drive space, 30 gigabytes. And they need Windows 10, a 64-bit operating system, and advanced graphics card. I think I have the specs to play that game, but it seems like it's a very advanced game. They put a lot of thought into, Sega put a lot of thought into this game and hard work. So I'm looking forward to playing Sonic Frontiers. But first I want to get through Sonic Mania. And I also want to play Return to Monkey Island, because I'm a huge Monkey Island fan. I grew up playing Monkey Island, and that's really close to my heart, the adventure games. So without further ado, here's Sonic the Hedgehog 3 Ice Cap Zone. Sonic the Hedgehog 3 Ice Cap Zone with Act 2 Boss music as well, thrown in for good measure. So thank you, Fam4077. Hello, Nixel. Thank you, Ricky. Yes, I can't wait to play Sonic Frontiers as well, David Sumner. Hello, Jameson. Welcome back. David Sumner writes, my left hand used to get fatigued playing the octaves in the left hand. I realized my wrists were too tense eventually. Yes, that's really, playing the octaves is tricky because it's about knowing when to release the tension when you're playing the octaves. So it's a technical issue because you may know how the rhythm goes and everything and play it with two hands. But the key to playing that left hand, I know there are a lot of pianists, a lot of people that play the piano here, and so I think this is relevant to a lot of people in the chat. So when to release the tension is really important because you have to know how to release tension, or else you will accumulate tension in, for example, the wrist, and you could get injured. So the trick is to release the tension after tensing to play these octaves. And also to use this wave-like motion of the arm to play. So it's not a mechanical locked motion, but it's more of a wave-like motion of the arm, and also to attack the key from different angles. So when you're playing this, it's about approaching the key from a different angle rather than the same angle. So as I'm moving my wrist this way, then I'm attacking the key from different angles. So you might want to practice this as an exercise. Play this 5 times at 16th notes in a 4/4 meter. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That almost sounds like the 9 to 64 song. Song, Mike. Awesome, thank you. So the idea is to move the hand in different directions. So same thing as doing this, rather than keeping the wrist locked like this, you want to approach the key from a different angle because you can get repetitive motion injury like that if you just do the same motion at the same time. Same thing with this. Turn the etude number 3 in D major, auto finger dexterity opus 740. So it's the same thing. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it's just sort of flip motion with the wrist, also initiated by the tricep muscle as well, from using the arm this way. So it's about that quick release. So then, it's also about expressing emotion and even a very short contact with the piano key. So even with the 16th note, when the finger is in contact with the key for just a split second, maybe like 3 to 5 hundredths of a second, when this occurs, just one note, it's important to still express emotion. And the shorter the contact of the fingers with the key, the harder it is because it's just less time. So that's why I believe if somebody can play the Super Mario Brothers theme well, expressively, then they can play almost any video game music piece that exists within reason, because actually the Super Mario Brothers theme is very hard to play on the piano, not in terms of rhythm, but in expressiveness, because everything is staccato, and if everything is played staccato mechanically, expressiveness, but if you find the expression in even the contact with the keys for a split second, that's the key. So it's the same thing here. And it takes a lot of practice, of course, but that's the direction you'd want to work on. You want to go in that direction. All right, so. That was a LeChuck theme, by the way. So again, follow me on Twitter. If you have any other questions or comments, I can reply to you. Could have like a conversation on Twitter. But again, maybe I might migrate from Twitter to another platform. Hello, Mario Guy 64. All right, and the stream is almost coming to end. It's actually getting late. I do have to cook dinner, and then I want to play Sonic Mania, and then I want to play Return to Monkey Island, then I want to play Sonic Frontiers, and then there are other games I want to play. There's just a ton of other games I want to play. But thank you, Fam477, Silent Hill not tomorrow, if not today or tomorrow, the next time. Yeah, Silent Hill not tomorrow. Yes, I know that song. It's been a while since I played that. I know how it goes a little bit. Sheet music for that. Christopher Antonio, yes, that is the pink elephant in the room, so to speak, but you know, there's some reasons that are valid reasons to stay and some valid reasons to leave, but and there are security issues as well. I mean, a lot of Twitter employees left, and so there's, I'm keeping track of what's going on with that situation there, and then verified profiles. Anybody can pay $8 or to be verified. Kind of dilutes the esteem or prestige of having a verified badge. If anybody can pay a certain amount of money to. Like $8 to be verified. So it's verified, but it's a different definition of verified, I think. I might stay on Twitter. There are people that I enjoy talking to on Twitter, and there's, you know, a lot of video game news and video game related tweets. So yeah, but then if a lot of people migrate to another platform and there's that people talk about video games and video game music on another platform, then that might be something I might do as well. But I'll also on stream on Twitch too. So there's a tweet that Mr. Beast made recently, or I don't know recently, but he said, and I paraphrase, that if you want to do something on the internet, do something that nobody has done before, or else you're wasting your time. So I kind of agree, I kind of disagree with that because, yes, being original is difficult to do these days, but at the same time, it's also the quality that matters too. So, like, for example, a lot of people in Mozart's time, a lot of people were composing music, but it was the quality and genius of Mozart that made him recognized by the kings and queens of his time. So, it's not just being original, but also quality as well, I believe. So, but I like piano and chess as well. So, and there's a big chess community on Twitter. So that's not on Twitter, but on Twitch. So that's where I would do the stream for piano chess, not on YouTube. There are some YouTubers that stream on YouTube, that stream chess on YouTube, but there's a huge chess community on Twitch. And that was when famous esports players started taking lessons with elite chess grandmasters, and then their audience migrated or became interested in chess. So that's how the chess community, the boom in the chess community on Twitch, started, I believe. So here is Silent Hill Not Tomorrow. Thank you for your patience, fam 4077. Thank you, fam 4077 for the super chat of Silent Hill Not Tomorrow. And it's time to end the stream. Time went by pretty fast for the stream, but stay tuned for the next stream. There'll be another stream soon on YouTube. So thank you all for joining. And thank you to the following people who made a super chat and or a super sticker. Sent a super chat and a super sticker rather. Thank you to Mikey Yan, fam 4077, and yet again fam 4077. Thank you everybody, and I'll end with the credits theme from Super Mario World. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Lighthouse, Ricky, Mikey, Ann, Pink Moose Tree. Welcome back. And thank you again, Fram4077. And welcome back, Nixel. Thank you. Thank you, Christopher Antonio, Lighthouse, MarioGuy64, Happenstance. Thank you so much. You are cool as well. All right. So hope to see you again next time. Bye-bye.